Konnichiwa. Hello, everybody. I'm Goro Koto from Japan Advocacy Network for Drug Policy. I deeply thank harm reduction, everybody and harm reduction, International Harm Reduction Committee to choose my abstract. I will be very honored to be here. And also, this is my very first time that my English is translated into French. So for people who are hearing from in French, if you hear something weird, it's my bad English. It's not the interpreters, you know. So don't blame on them and blame on me. And I really appreciate your hard work for the interpreters. Thank you very much. So I'd like to present about challenge of harm reduction advocacy in the Japan social values of morality. So I briefly start from sharing the situation in my country. So we have 130 million population, and 98% of us are Japanese, so we are a very homogeneous country. And we have a very strict punitive drug prohibition, so drug use is crime, not health issues. And government says once you use drugs, you ruin your life. And people believe punitive punishment works. And also people surrender to police to quit using drugs, and they don't go to hospitals because the doctors report their patients to the police. And so we have some recovery program of NA. NA is very huge in Japan, so that's maybe the only one, NA, and some TC, 12-step self-help group TCs. And some hospitals do CBT programs, but it's very rare because hospitals, you know, report to the police. And so under this circumstance, there is some very limited number of people who said it's going to be this is something wrong, so we should do something, think about drug policy reform. So Japan Advocacy Network for Drug Policy is obviously for the advocacy network for, you know, drug policy reform, and it was established in November 2015. And that is only 3 members, including me, and I'm the only one paid part-time staff, just working 1 days a week. So I come here 6 days here, so which means I'm working for 1 month. And so, in the past year, I joined CND, I joined ANGAS, and I also joined Asian Fellowship Program conducted by Lilies in London, and I got a very good, you know, course there, of course, and received a very fantastic mentoring by Edward Fox. I really appreciate him. And I also joined Train the Trainers in Bali, conducted by IDPC. It's a drug policy reform in Asia, and I met a lot of fantastic Asian activists there. And personally, back to 2004 and 5, I was a student of Columbia University School of Social Work, and I was very lucky to have a chance of doing internship at Harm Reduction Coalition. In those days, Mr. Alan Creer was the executive director, and without this internship, I wouldn't be standing here today. So I'm also really appreciate the current Harm Reduction Coalition, of course, and everybody who support our activities. So I'll go back to my presentation. So in the past year, we did kind of informal, casual meetings, workshops, lectures on harm reduction and decriminalization. And we have various participants, like government officials, people who use drugs, family members, healthcare project professionals, legal professionals, general citizens. And we did a lot of discussions, and we got a lot of feedback. And so when we think, okay, what we do next, what we make strategy, we kind of reviewed all the feedbacks, and we analyzed, and so what we discussed is like this. So I don't know if I'm good at explaining this, but so we have, in our culture, we have a very strong moral standard. So society is, you know, prioritized much more over individuals, and social morality is much more prioritized over human rights. So I hardly learn about human rights in school, but we learn a lot about social morality. And so what is good, what is bad for social, in terms of social morality. So it helps us to develop, you know, stigma and discrimination against, no, discrimination, sorry, discrimination against people who use illicit drugs and people living with HIV, AIDS, etc. And because they broke laws, I mean, especially people who use illicit drugs in this sense, then so they are bad guys, and they themselves also take this is a very bad, and we, and you know, they don't take like, our human rights are disregarded. They even have any idea of their human rights. I mean, that it's very happened. I mean, because we don't learn about how, you know, human rights, we don't have the identification of like what is our human rights, something like this. So, and in the society, we have very small number of people who use drugs. Drug use in the past year is 0.1%, and small number of people who share needles, ID use among people with HIV and AIDS is 0.5%. And we have good hepatitis C treatment, so which is available, that is very good. But we don't have any like a ghetto, geographical ghetto. So, you know, poverty is, we have a big problem of poverty, but there is no place that like syringes and needles are discarded. And we don't use, many people, I mean, we don't use heroin. So methamphetamine is the most popular drugs in my country. So in this sense, people easily to say we have no need of OSD, no need of NSP, no need of injection consumption room, or no need of overdose prevention for opioids. And but so when we talk about harm reduction, okay, so let's think about what is harm in our society. And people easily say it's crime because they, you know, drug people who use drugs broke the law, and so reduction means punishment or exclusion. And they said evidence-based, yes, strict punishment works in our country, that people saying. And cost effectiveness, yeah, it's okay, but it's worthwhile to put that money and to exclude, you know, criminals from the society. So there's a like very typical like people saying, you know, harm reduction is no need of harm reduction, or okay, I like harm reduction to make drug-free world come true. So it's also wrong. And so we say, but people saying, so do we need harm reduction in Japan? And of course it is, we need it because, you know, the social, our policy really, you know, ruining the life of people who use drugs and their families, their partners, their loved ones. And it also impacts a lot internationally. For example, our country decided to give $35 million to Philippines to support their drug rehabilitation, that it says, but it may be used for, we are afraid that it may be used for building up compulsory treatment center. So so we really need harm reduction, and because not because number, the small number of people who use drugs, but because the strong stigma, and I can hardly find anybody who say I'm harm reductionist in my country. So our challenge is design harm reduction without major harm reduction programs. So we never have any experience of OSD, NSP consumption room in my country. So people don't see somebody who maintains their health because of OSD, or like I had, and because of NSP, I can avoid from, you know, infection or something like that. We have never see these people. But internationally, when it comes to harm reduction programs, it's basically OSD, NSP, consumption room, and overdose prevention. So it's very hard to say, like people easily, you know, switch that harm reduction program is just like them, so we don't need them, which means we don't need harm reduction. So we need to fight for them, and so of course we need to advocate a lot in my country domestically. So what we did last year is, because of the limited kind of resources we do, and there is, first of all, we have no resources written in Japanese harm reduction and decriminalization, because again, 98% of people are Japanese, they basically don't use English. So the resources materials are in Japanese and written by Japanese people who never experienced of harm reduction. So of course we cannot, you know, expect that we have some materials in Japanese related to harm reduction and decriminalization. So we picked up many, not some basic materials, and we translated it into Japanese. So that is what we could do so far. But so because that's 1 year we spent at this moment. So now we are going to our next step. So we're gonna create education tools from this translation, and we disseminate this information in using like a Facebook or SNS, blogs, websites. And we, then first of all, I really would like to find somebody who can work together, because I'm just kind of expecting if I can see somebody from Japan in this conference who can work with us, who are harm reductionist, who say I'm harm reductionist, is there anybody here? Of course, not surprising. And so, I feel very, very excited to deal with this challenge, because we have a lot we can do, and I'm really, excited. And because I feel very motivated and encouraged by all of you here, I know how much difficulties or tough situation you have been dealt with so far, so I can learn a lot from all of you, so I really, really appreciate you being with us. ありがとうございました。 Thank you very much.